What's going on, everybody? Josh Engelman for AwesomeO.com, and I am back with my NBA DFS contenders on DraftKings for Thursday, March 25th. Now, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know when this and all of our other content goes live. Follow me on Twitter, at Josh Engelman, so you can get updates to the sim results as we get closer to lock. Finally, let me know in the comments section who is your favorite and least favorite of my contenders for today's slate. We round out the bottom of my top 10 with Kelly Oubre, Jordan Poole, Andrew Wiggins, Avicii Zubac, and CJ McCollum on the outside looking in. Who will be my favorites? My top five plays for today? It is time to find out. First up at number five, we're going to the point guard spot, $8,700 De'Aaron Fox, projected for 47.5. The goal is 52.5. He is in the optimal lineup 26% of the time. Now, these guys are playing huge minutes for the Kings. I've got him in for 37 at 1.28 fantasy points per minute. This is a massive pace up spot for the Kings. They gain 3.4 possessions over their average. That is huge. That's like an extra point and a half for De'Aaron Fox. 31% usage, 26-8-5 with two stocks. No Corey Joseph around either, so not like Fox is going to lose minutes, but that certainly helps. A matchup against Golden State is really fantastic, and $8,700 for a guy with a GPP goal of just 50, he's only 5 points shy of that just in general. He hits that goal 32% of the time. He's a no-brainer today. The raw point ceiling is just too high. Next up at number four, we're going to the shooting guard spot, $7,800 Paul George. I love this one. Now, it's a relatively pace neutral spot against San Antonio, but I've got him projected for 43 fantasy points. The goal is 49, and he's in the optimal lineup 27% of the time. Full minutes here, 36 minutes, 1.2 fantasy points per minute. Big usage, we know that, 29%, 23.5 points, 6 boards, 5 assists. You get a steal and a half, maybe you fall into a block. It would be awesome. I don't mind running up against San Antonio. It's not the best slate in the world, but to get someone like Paul George, a high-end per-minute fantasy performer that plays 36 minutes a game at a sub-$8,000 price tag, I don't see how you can go a different direction. Next up at number three, center-eligible Montrezl Harrell. He's $7,000, projected for 38. The goal is 46, and he's in the optimal lineup 28% of the time. Harrell's just playing monstrous minutes. Even without starting, he's still getting north of 30. I've got him in for 32, projected for 1.2 fantasy points per minute against Philly with still no Joel Embiid. This is actually a pace-up spot for the Lakers. 26% usage, 21-9. Not doing a ton else, but you're not really worried about it. It's Harrell against Dwight Howard or Tony Bradley. He's not having to run into Joel Embiid in this spot. That is fantastic news for the Lakers. The price is starting to climb, and it's making me a little bit nervous, but given the amount of minutes he's playing, given his per-minute rates, I'm going to happily pay $7,000 for Montrezl Harrell. Now, at the number two spot, we're looking for a little bit of value. That's small forward, power forward, eligible Derrick Jones Jr. He's just $3,900 today, projected for 22. The goal is 36, but he's in the optimal lineup 29% of the time. You need some pay-down options, and the flexibility at position helps a lot. He's played north of 30 minutes in three out of his last four games. He's only a 0.74 guy. It's a pace down spot. It's a terrible matchup against Miami. But I'm taking a bet on the minutes and the price tag here. Minimal usage. It's only 9 points, 5 boards, and one of every other stat category. The difference here is no Nas Little and no Anfernee Simons because they are in the health and safety protocols. Derrick Jones Jr. has played 30 minutes out of the last three, and those two guys are out. So I think those minutes feel firm. And we'll go revenge narrative. I think that his defensive setup against Miami fits a little bit better. So I'm expecting him to get those 30 minutes again. He's not the great per minute performer that you're looking for. I'm hoping his ownership is a little bit lower, but it's sub $4,000, small forward, power forward, forward and utility. That flexibility allows you to pay up a little bit more across the other positions. Now, before we get to that number one contender, one last reminder, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you know when everything goes live, then head on over to Twitter, follow me, at Josh Engelman, so you can get the updates to my sim results, then slide underneath this video into the comment section and let me know who your favorite and least favorite contender is, and if it's somebody that I didn't mention, let me know who you're looking at for today's slate. And now the no-brainer number one option today, Tyrese Haliburton. Point guard, shooting guard eligible. Just 6K, projected for 35.7, goal is 43. Optimal lineup, you guessed it, 39% of the time. That's 10% higher than Derek Jones Jr. No-brainer here. 36 minutes. They don't have Corey Joseph anymore, so those minutes are even more firm to me. Fantasy point per minute, or 0.99 if you don't want to round up. 18% usage, 16 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists. You get a steal and a half. That massive pace up spot against Golden State, a defense that isn't all that great. You're not really worried about it. All signs point to Tyrese Haliburton today. He's the number one contender on FanDuel. Spoiler alert if you haven't watched that yet. And he's the number one contender on DK. I don't see a way around it. Barring any really weird trades creating some huge value today, and that could certainly happen on the trade. Alrighty, folks, that will do it. Those are my NBA DFS contenders on DraftKings for Thursday, March 25th. Process show is already in the books. Go watch that. I'm on the strategy show with Adam Kaufman today. Watch that at 10 a.m. And then no live before lock for me today. Keep your eyes peeled at 6:30 Eastern time. That should be when I post my updates to my sim results. And then we've got one more day ahead of us. Contenders again tomorrow morning. So good luck tonight, everybody. I'll catch you guys again in the a.m.